one that wrote down my testimony. So he said, I guess my wife's sharing her testimony Sunday. Like Billy Chuck said, I had to pray about it, but I already knew that I was supposed to step on out of the boat and share my testimony. So I'm stepping out of the boat. I'm going to read it. I'm not a speaker, so I'm just going to read what I've written down. And I'll probably cry because writing it, I kept crying just because of the goodness of God. Before being saved, I always did whatever to fit in. I had a lot of friends, quote friends, but I was always exhausted because I was so tired of trying to please my friends and the people around me. I was with men who disrespected me, lied to me, cheated on me, emotionally and mentally abused me, told me I would never get any better. I had low self-esteem, no self-worth. I was always trying who I wanted to be, just to please a man. I never felt worthy of finding true love. Two of my biggest dreams in life were to get married and have children. And I had a list, you know, and I wanted a tall, dark, handsome man that would love me with all of his heart, and not just love me, but that would sing to me, because I love a man that would sing. But the enemy again said to me, what makes you think you're worth that? You're stupid if you believe that you deserve that. You're stupid if you believe that you can have a list of what you want in a man. You're not pretty enough. You're too fat. You've done too many wrongs to have a list of what you want in a man. You're not good enough. I did have two amazing sons during this crazy time of my life, which I love with all of my heart. I remember sitting in a Sunday night service, and I was so overwhelmed. I was sobbing. I had the weight of the world on my shoulders. I was so tired of trying to please everybody and just trying to do everything on my own, and I wanted something so different. I appeared happy, but it was all to cover up. And I just wanted to be the best mom I could be to my sons. So I stepped out in faith and surrendered to the Lord. And even still, I was so afraid of missing out on something, losing friends, whatever. You know, there's just always the enemy had something in the back of my mind where it said, you don't need to do this. But I did it anyways. That night, not just that night, that moment that I stepped out, I felt the greatest love I've ever felt. I felt the most joy that I've ever felt. And most of all, I was so relieved. My burdens weren't heavy anymore. I didn't have anything on my shoulders or my back. I just knew that God was with me. As I began my journey with Him, He shared with me that I have to put Him first in all things. All things. He freed me from disrespectful men. Showed me that I didn't need them. He told me, He said, you just put me first. You focus on me. And I will place a man in front of you. You don't have to look for him. I'm not the one that you're supposed to be with. You don't have to look for this man. So yeah. I'll place him right in front of you. So I had many friends, you know, do you want to go out with this person? I'm going to set you up. No, God has a man for me. I refused to date. I didn't want to date. I didn't want to meet anybody. Nothing. I just knew I had to focus on God. So He also freed me from drinking. Showed me that nothing ever good came out of those nights that I chose to go to the bars. Which in turn freed me from cigarettes because I only smoked when I went out to drink. When I feel overwhelmed with fear, He comforts me. provides for me. Like James already shared, he provided a car for us. That's unbelievable to me. It just amazes me. When I'm sick, he heals me. The doctor said I had cancer, but God, he healed me.
Amen.
He fulfills the desires of my heart. As I said earlier, I had a very specific list of a man that I wanted. And he placed James in my life, which fulfills everything on my list and more.
Praise the Lord.
God said, I told you, I'll bring him to you. You didn't need to waste time. And he did. He placed him right in my heart at just the right time. Even still, the enemy would say, you're kidding me if you think you're good enough to be a pastor's wife. You're kidding me. But God said, I believe in you, and I love you. This is going to be your husband. And so, sorry, I lost my place. And I've also shared my other dream was to have kids. So not only did I have the two boys, I have five amazing kids.
Amen.
They made me so proud, and I love so much. So God does fulfill the desires of your heart, and he loves us. My salvation took me from feeling lost, overwhelmed, having low self-esteem, feeling unworthy, and full of fear, and filled me with love, peace, joy, comfort, happiness. And God continues to show me he's my all in all, everything I stand in need of. At the, we went to a conference Friday, sister-to-sister conference, and Sheila Walsh was there. She said to us when we, she said, what if I let you guys all walk in, and I said, up on that big screen is going to be a movie of your life, where everybody would see everything you've ever done, everything you've ever thought, and everything you've ever said. Everybody was going to see it. And just the thought of that made me so sick to my stomach. It really made me sick to my stomach. So, but then she, in turn, said, God's already seen your movie, and he loves you.
Right.
Trying to be braver than I could ever. name.
Thank you.
Sorry about this. I can't. I'm playing. I can't hear anything.
God will always win out. Go ahead, God will throw whatever you want.
Thank you. Yeah. told me why he wanted this song played, but it's not my testimony to give, so I don't feel comfortable giving it. It's Toby's testimony, so give it to me.
Actually, it's not mine, it's my wife. Now, about 4 years ago, we went to Gaither's concert, Mom. Me and my mother-in-law, Patty. And this song was played. And at that time, I was going through my drug addiction, addicted to pain pills. And my rock, as I refer to her, went and ran and got this tape, this CD. And as I sat back there, I kept on thinking, man, I'm feeling sorry for myself. I'm just going to make a statement. Enough is enough. Found out my wife's got diabetes. Found out, they finally told me that they're testing me, my daughter for cancer. The things I've been going through, they cannot find out why I'm having to lose 7 times in the past year, 7, 4 times. But this song is her song, and that's why I want you to play it this morning.
Alright, so the Holy Spirit is speaking something in my heart, and if I don't share it, then I'm just, I don't know, I get this feeling that I'm just going to explode. Many of you know that God has worked so many things in our life, and He knows our testimony, where our faith has taken us, but I have even more news that God has done in our lives. So, about 2 years ago, I made this whole prayer list of things that, you know, I asked God to do in our lives. And God has answered so many of them. But one that I've really been praying on is my daughter, or our daughter, Riley, has intellectual cognitive disability. Most of you wouldn't know that when talking to her. She has, her language is, you know, beautiful. She can say so many things, but her function in the back of her brain, it takes a lot longer for her to do or understand things that is normal for us, like tying her shoes or using the bathroom or, you know, whatever it may be. So it took many years of us to potty train her, to learn to buckle her seatbelt, you know, all of these things that is just normal for typical children to do. It took a lot longer for her. Well, her teacher advised us in a way without, you know, asking us to put her on that we should put her on medication for ABD because she has trouble concentrating on her work. And I was like, no, no, you know, I don't want Riley to lose her beautiful spark. Because if anybody knows Riley, Riley is a unique individual who gives lots of hugs, full of so much energy and love, and I didn't want her to lose that because that's how God created her. Right. Nothing against medication. Some children do need medication, but I didn't feel that was right for Riley. So I had a prayer that God would help her, you know, educationally so that she could, you know, get to where she needed to be. So this year, or this school year, her goal was to know 20 sight words. She's in third grade. So her goal was to know 20 sight words, and she now knows 100 sight words. So she over. She was at a kindergarten reading level when she started this year, and she is now beginning at a second grade reading level.
Yes. Amen.
And I just wanted to share that you know, God can move in your life.
Right.
Thank you. Bible's on my phone, one of my Bibles. And so I use it pretty much. And when I'm looking at things, I go there. But I go to Romans, the 8th chapter. I was really going to start a series on the cross. And if you came because you saw on our Facebook that we're going to do 6 weeks on the cross, I want to tell you, you want to come and hear what God has to say to you about the cross.